Welcome to the homework for lesson 18. This is module 5 of grade 3. Write your name here first. Place the two fractions on the number line. Circle the fraction with the distance closest to 0. Then compare them using greater than, less than, or equal to. And the hint for remembering which way to point those, you might remember alligator eats the larger number. In this case, would be the larger fraction. So these are thirds, and we're in between 0 and 1. So we need 1 third and 2 thirds. So we just need to mark. And if we want to label every single fraction there, we could, but we don't really have to. We just have to place the two fractions, 1 third and the 2 thirds. We don't have to label the 0 thirds or the 3 thirds. You can if you want. If it's a habit, you just always have to do it. You can. It helps you to count and know where everything is. But you should know where 1 third and 2 thirds are here without having to do that. So here we charted those and circle the fraction with the distance closest to 0. So 1 third is closest to 0. And then compare them. So 1 third is less than 2 thirds. And now we're looking at denominators of 6. So we need sixths. That's going to look like that's the halfway mark there. And now I need thirds for each half. It's about as good as I'm going to get it. And well, those are not very good, but I'll go with it. And I can fix these. That's better. Now we need 4/6 and 1/6. So we're going to find here's this would be 0, 6. So here's 1 sixth. And then 4 sixths means 1, 2, 3, 4. There's the fourth sixth. And circle the one closest to 0. And 4 sixths is greater than 1 sixth. And now we need fourths and eighths. Oh, beauty. So we're going to need eighths and fourths. So let's start with, you guessed it, halves. And halves need fourths when you fold them in half again. So now we have fourths marked. Now we can label one fourth, right? Because we know where that is. It's right here. It's the first fourth. One fourth. Now we do the eighths, and the eighths are marked in between the fourths. Fourths are also eighths. But the first eighth, we know where that one is now. That's right here, one eighth. So that wasn't so bad. We had to don't have to label all of them in both fourths and eighths. And which one is closest to zero? That's one eighth. So one fourth is greater than one eighth. Now we have 4/5 and 4/10. Tenths are, there's twice as many tenths as there are fifths. So let's mark fifths, just like we do with fourths and eighths. We'll mark the fifths first, then we'll find 4/5. Then we'll find 4/10 afterwards. So let's see, we'll mark the fifths. We need four lines for fifths, and that's going to be about, that could be a fifth. And there, there, and then another one here. That's pretty good. All right. So we need 4/5. So that's 0, 1, 2, 3. This one is the 4/5. There. And now we need tenths. So the tenths go in between the fifth marks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we need the 4/10. One. Well, let me mark these with black so you can see me count them. One, 2, 3, 4. So that's 4 tenths there. And that's the one that's closest to 0. And we can see now that 4 fifths is greater than 4 tenths. And now we're looking at sixths and thirds. So since thirds are greater, and it turns out there's twice as many sixths as there are thirds, because 6 is double 3, we're going to be able to do the same trick again, where we do the thirds first. Notice we are in between 1 and 2. So we still need to, that's between two whole numbers, so we're still going to have thirds to start with. But we're going to label them differently. So this 1 is going to really be 3 thirds, isn't it? So that's 3 thirds. So that's, this one is 4 thirds, and this one is going to be 5 thirds. There. And now to get sixths, we'll make marks in between the thirds. There, there, and there. And now we should have six, right? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6. We have 6, 6. So now we want the 8th, 6th. So where is that? Well, 1 is how many sixths? 1 is 6 sixths, right? Because it takes all 6 sixths to have a whole. So we only need 7 sixths would be the next one, and then the one after that is 8 sixths, and that's the one we're looking for. 8 sixths, and that's the closest one to 0. And so 8 sixths is less than 5 thirds. Liz and Jay each have a piece of string. Liz's string is 4/6 of a yard long, and Jay's string is 5/7 of a yard long. Whose string is longer? Draw a number line to model the length of both strings. Explain the comparison using pictures, numbers, and words. So, this is going to be Liz's string. And this is going to be Jay's string. They're both different distances, but I'm going to make each one of these number lines, each of these number lines, I'm going to label these from 0 to 1. 0 to 1 in yards. Now Liz has hers in sixths, and Jay has his in sevenths. This is really going to be, this is going to be a real pain, because it's just, these fractions are going to be really close to each other, and it's going to be hard to tell just by looking. Sixths are Liz's, right? So she's got, we need sixths. So that's 1, and we'll try to make thirds. And then Jay has sevenths. Sevenths are a little less. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. All right, so Jay has, we need 5/7. So that's 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then Liz's string is 4/6, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4 there. Whose string is longer? Okay, so did that. And explain the comparison using pictures, numbers, and words. Now, here's a way of thinking of it. that may help you make sense of this. I'll use the kind of the gray marker here. You notice that each one of these is missing two parts for the whole yard. Since Liz's string, right, that's 4 is 1 is 2 less than 6 and 5 is 2 less than 7. So they're each missing two parts. So since Liz's string is in sixths, her parts that are missing are larger. So that means she has more missing, her string is going to be shorter. And Jay's string is missing two parts also, but his parts are sevenths, and sevenths are smaller. So he's missing the same number of parts, but they're smaller parts. So he's going to be missing less of his string, which means he's going to have more. So his string is going to be longer. And it's very difficult to get between sixth and sevenths. It's very difficult to show the difference between these. So you have to get it just, you almost have to be really lucky just to have it show up and look as good as I had it here. It's usually sevenths. You know, a lot of times I'll just get it wrong. But that's kind of how you try to draw the picture. Using pictures, numbers, and words. Now I have to find a way to kind of write down what I just said about the missing pieces. You might be able to think of a better way to say it than I do if that makes sense to you. You might have to say something different. If it doesn't, don't try to write something that doesn't make sense, because you can't explain something you don't understand. But this picture should answer the question. Don't forget to answer the question. Whose string is longer? Jay's string. We're going to start with that. Because we don't forget to answer the question, actually. Jay's string is longer. Both are missing two pieces. And Jay's pieces are smaller. Shorter. Okay, so we'll just leave it at that. I don't want to have to write a whole paragraph for that. I don't have room for it anyway. In a long jump competition, Wendy jumped 9/10 of a meter and Judy jumped 10/9 of a meter. Draw a number line to model the distance of each girl's long jump. Who jumped the shorter distance? Explain how you know. Okay, so Wendy... Here's Wendy's, and we can draw, we don't have to make a number line. It doesn't say we have to use a number line. We have Wendy and Judy. So we can draw tape diagrams. I like tape diagrams, so I'm drawing them. Now we need, Wendy needs tenths. So that's half of a tenth, which is 5/10. I mean half of a, that's 5/10 there. So I need five parts on each side of that halfway mark for tenths. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is, we're going to call this, remember our endpoints, they're both going to start at 0. And this we're going to call 1 meter. Right, and so Wendy 9/10. We want to see these fraction marks in between, so don't totally shade this in, because we want to see how far it goes. We want to see where those fractional lines are. Now, Judy's is in ninths, and it's not going to matter, really, fortunately for us. Let's see, we can do three sets of three for nine. So there's thirds, and then we can make each third into thirds, and then we'll have ninths. And she needs, Judy has 10 ninths. So this right here is 1 ninth. This is going to be 2 ninths. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The whole meter is 9 ninths. So she's going to need another ninth. Right, we can label these if we wanted to. But you really don't have to label all of them, and I'm not gonna. So, Judy, who jumped a shorter distance, almost forgot. Wendy. Jumped shorter. She jumped less than 1 meter, and Judy jumped over 1 meter. Nikki has three pieces of yarn. The first piece is 5/6 feet long. The second piece is 5/3 feet long. And the third piece is 3/2 feet long. She wants to arrange them from shortest to longest. Draw a number line to model the length of each piece of yarn. Okay, so we have to draw a number line for each piece of yarn, and then write a number sentence using this, less than, greater than, or equal to compare the pieces. Explain using pictures, numbers, and words. Okay, so the pictures are going to be our number lines, and the numbers are going to be the numbers on our labeling our number lines, and the words are going to be our answer statement. So we need a piece that's in sixths. And these are all going to be, 5/6, 5/3 is more than a foot, but it's less than 2, and 3/2 is more than a foot, but it's less than 2 feet. So I'm going to label these. We want to keep our endpoints matched up, right? So we're going to start these at 0. But I'm just going to do the first one first. Don't try to do everything all at once. 0, and then so halfway in between will be 1, and at the end will be 2 feet. That's 1 foot. Okay, so the first piece is 5/6 of a foot long. So 5/6 is going to be, we need sixths, right? So that's going to be here. Is half, and now we need 2 sets of thirds. And 5/6, so 1 whole foot would be 6/6, so 5 is going to be the one just before it. And I'm going to label that 5/6. And now that's first piece. Label these. Second piece is 5/3. So same, try and get these all to line up, right, for 0. And trying to get this to go all the way here to stop at 2 feet. And then we'll put the 1 foot line here at the same part. Now we need 5/3. So each. Now we need thirds instead of sixths. So here, and then two more should be our other third. They should kind of line up. And they're not great because my marks aren't perfect. But we need thirds in between 1 and 2 feet. So here we go. There's there. So 3/3 is 1 whole foot. This would be, so this is 3/3. That's 4/3. And this is going to be 5/3. So I'm going to label that 5/3. And then third piece is 3/2. Okay, so here's our line. And there's our 1 foot mark. And now we just need halves in between these. There. So this would be 1/2 here and 2/2 there, and this is going to be 3/2. So this is 3/2. All right, so now we can see where they are. I'm going to put some boxes around them just so we can really see them. There's the 5/6, there's the 5/3, and there's the 3/2. And if you think about this, okay, the 5/6 has to be the smallest one because it's the only one that's less than 1. So 5/6 is going to be less than the one that's in the middle, right? We're going to have a small, a medium, and a large. And the alligator keeps eating the larger number. So which one's the biggest? 5/3. And the one in the middle is 3/2.